Hey everyone, welcome to Plants and Politics. So Michael Cohen, as you probably know, is was Trump's longtime personal attorney, and he recently went to prison for Trump's crimes, essentially for crimes that he aided Trump in committing. Trump somehow, as usual, you know, dodged all charges. And the only reason he's not in prison right now, along with Michael Cohen, is because he's sitting president and because of a ridiculous memo, which is not law, that nobody has the ovaries to challenge. But I digress. The reason I wanted to bring this information to you is because Michael Cohen has launched or is launching a new weekly podcast. It's going to start on Monday, September 28th, and it is called Mea Culpa. So the name, of course, is Cohen's way of acknowledging his part and that he's to blame for where we find ourselves today with a literal sociopath sitting in the White House and in control of the nuclear codes. Cohen's first guest is Omarosa Manigault. I barely like Omarosa more than Trump. I mean, I can't stand either of them, but yeah, she's barely acceptable. The one good thing is, though, she is speaking out. Hopefully she's being honest. In Cohen's interview with Manigault, she tells him that she has recordings of Donald Trump's daughter-in-law, Laura Trump, who is, of course, married to Eric, and she dishes the dirt on the Trump family. She said, quote, "Let's be clear. I have Laura badmouthing Ivanka. I have Laura badmouthing Donald. I have Laura badmouthing Melania. The reason why Laura doesn't say much about me is because if she recalls all the conversations we had, particularly when we were on the Women for Trump bus tour, she was saying some things that I think the family would be quite interested in." And Manigault also alleges that Laura Trump contacted her after she was fired from her White House position and offered to pay for her silence. Now, this was something she said before, but I think it's, you know, worth repeating. She said, quote, "And she was explicit. We will pay you this money, but you can't be saying those things, those bad things." So I, for one, will be listening to this podcast. I know people are angry with Cohen. I have been as well. I just believe that we need to stop applying what I refer to as selective redemption. We agree to accept and bring back into the fold people that we choose, but then some people we just reject completely. And no matter what they try to do to make up for their past transgressions, we just say no. No, there is no redemption for you. You cannot be redeemed. You cannot make amends, and you're done. And I've taken part in cancel culture as well. So I'm not going to sit here and be a hypocrite and say cancel culture is so horrible. I think we really need to look at the person. We need to look at what exactly they did and there's, of course, certain things that you never forgive. You never forgive someone like a Jeffrey Epstein or a Ghislaine Maxwell who victimized children. I think that that is just horrific. But Cohen did not physically harm anyone. Yes, his lies, his cheating, his underhanded actions allowed this egomaniacal, narcissistic grifter to take over our country. And guess what? He paid the ultimate price. He lost everything. He went to prison. His family was shamed and humiliated. People can change. People can absolutely change. And I believe that when something that huge occurs in your life, when you have something like, hey, I went to prison. He was an attorney. He held a fairly prestigious role in the Trump organization. I just think that when you have a moment like this, when you have a really impactful event, you go one of two ways. You either wake up and you realize that you've been going down the wrong road, or you dig in and you get worse. Fortunately for Cohen, he had children and a wife who kept trying to wake him up. And it sounds like from his book, which I'm reading, his parents, his in-laws, they all wanted him to quit working for Trump. And they harassed him about it for the full decade that he was there at the Trump Organization. They didn't like it. They seemed like good people. They understood that Trump was trouble, and they tried to move him away from Trump. And so luckily he had that other influence in his life to help him see the error of his ways. And he seems like someone who's genuinely trying to make amends for the pain and the suffering that he's caused and for his really egregious actions. And so I hope that people will give him a chance. I believe that he's sincere and that he truly understands how horrific this is. Again, I'm reading his book, and it's almost unbelievable the level of depravity that Trump didn't force him, but asked him to take part in, the things that they did, the way they cheated people, the lies that they told. I mean, Trump, seriously, my biggest takeaway from the book so far is that Trump is a bottomless pit of self-loathing and insecurity, and he just needs, he absolutely must have constant praise, constant reassurance. He's really pathetic. All right, guys, as always, like, share, subscribe. I will talk to you soon. Take care. Thanks for listening to Plants and Politics. The only way we can take our country and power back is to spread the truth and build an army. So remember to like, follow, subscribe, and share on Facebook, YouTube, and wherever you listen to your podcasts. Thanks again.